Yeah. Okay. I think we have a lot of questions, but first, Mazam entrepreneur, how does it feel?
Well, thank you.
I mean, it's a completely new label, actor, we've seen. Now entrepreneur, it's heavy? You feel heavy? Is this a heavy label?
Oh, I'm excited. First of all, thank you so much, everyone, for being here with us today. And thank you so much, Kusha, for coming here today. I'm so happy that you could be here.
I'm so happy to be a part of this campaign, this entire brand. But I have to ask you, Katrina, how was it? Like, how are you as an entrepreneur?
Well, I don't know, but I mean, I'm learning from the best. I mean, honestly, I've got Falguni right here with me. And can I just say that, I mean, since I've always had a dream of launching my own beauty brand. It's been a dream of mine, it just seemed like such a huge task. And, you know, makeup right from the time I started as a model in my career to obviously, you know, my whole journey as an actor, it's such an important part of our everyday life. And I really wanted to create a product which would be long-lasting, extremely glamorous, but also care for your skin. Because to me, I mean, these things, it's all in the details, you know? You really want something that you know is actually good for your skin when you put it on. Yeah. And it just seemed like a lot to do. And when I found my partners with Falguni and Veena, who's going to be joining us shortly with Nykaa, it was kind of like love at first sight from the first meeting because I saw someone who shared my passion.
Yeah.
Now, I can be really, really hard on myself. And as hard as I am and how much I demand from myself, I also wanted that from the products and from, you know, the brand we were going to build together. And I saw that same passion in both Falguni and Veena. And without their team, without the way that their whole team has worked tirelessly, endless hours, and I mean that, endless hours for two years, I think, we've been creating this. Countless meetings, endless cups of coffee. These meetings in my house where the table just would look like, I mean, it would be covered in beauty products with samples and everything. And it was teamwork. And finally, here we are today at the launch of K-Beauty. And I couldn't be happier and I'm extremely excited.
So is it everything you'd imagined?
It's everything and more. It's so much fun. It's my dream. I mean, for me, I am a makeup girl. You know, like there are some girls who are into handbags, there are some girls who are into other things, but for me, it has been makeup. And I know makeup. I do makeup. So it's I know products. You know, like when me and Rina, who's, you know, she develops all the products, we would just sit and play. It was just like it was instantaneous. We would know what we wanted. We know what we liked. And I don't think we can have a better, you know, leader in terms of business and knowing the consumer than Falguni. And what's great for me is what I learned from Falguni is she's so precise with her decisions, you know? There's no uncertainty or, you know, hemming and hawing. She's clear. She knows where she's going, what she wants. And it's great because I feel like that we're all a team and we're on this exciting journey together and it's just starting.
And I feel like the thing you say about Falguni, I think that's why she's the boss. Because she's like quick, she's very decisive. But we're speaking about Rina, right? So now it's time for the other key Nykaa woman in the partnership today, who's Rina Chhabra, CEO Nykaa Brands. With over 20 years of experience in the beauty industry, she's one woman show when it comes to creating beauty brands. From identifying trends, picking innovative formulations, designing packaging, and directing production to sales. She's really done it all. Please welcome on stage Rina Chhabra.
Hi, Rina.
Hi.
So, Rina, I have a question straight up. So Katrina mentioned how she's worked very closely with you on K-Brands. How is she to work with? I think everybody wants to know.
Do we have time for that?
I would say that she drove us very hard. But at the end, I think we're so happy.
I think she drove us very hard in trying to find the right colors, the right formulation, what she wanted, what she didn't. The whole industry's heard how exacting she is. At the end, I think I can only say that we're very happy because the products have come out so well.
Yeah.
I think they're a formulation that you haven't seen. The colors are unique. They're as long-lasting. And, you know, they had to go through the rigor of all her shoots and last at the end of the shoot. So we are excited to launch this.
So what's the journey been like for you? Like the entire K-beauty journey, if you had to like quickly tell everybody in the room.
I think it's been very unique because, of course, as all people, you know, we were in awe of Katrina Kaif, the actress. What we did not realize is how knowledgeable she is about makeup and how hardworking she is and how she's put her heart and soul into the makeup. And thankfully, you know, because of that, she's also allowed us to carry the K logo on the product.
Yeah.
So very happy that Katrina gets her own monogram. And it's a lovely luxe offering that we've been able to make.
Katrina, give us a little insight into K-beauty. Why is it called K-beauty? I think everybody's curious in the room, right?
Well, we wanted something that had that resonated with my name, which is, you know, Katrina. And we didn't want to have, somehow it just wasn't, we weren't like feeling that just, you know, because a lot of people do put their names when they start something and they put their whole name. And it just kind of happened one day. And I think we just all unanimously felt that moment where we were like, yes, this is right. It just, I felt it was easy. You know, it's kind of, you know, you get it, K, Katrina, and it was a name which to me seemed really smooth.
Yeah.
And everyone loved it. Reena loved it. Falguni loved it. So we thought about it, and then we were like, yeah, this is sticking, and it just felt right.
It was the organic, obvious choice.
It was the organic, obvious choice, But, you know, I mean, right from the beginning, the first meeting, I'll never forget, where Falguni and Reena came, and I have a fairly small table, dining table, and the first meeting, it was very neat, and then gradually, as our meetings would progress, as we were into sample stages, choosing product, choosing packaging, and the whole Nykaa team, they have an office full of incredible girls, and that's, you know, all I need is their feedback. They used to come, and we would have these big makeup sessions where they would come with nice, you know, clean faces. Mm-hmm. And when they would leave my house, someone would have a blue eye, someone would have a brown eye, someone would have a red lip. Poor Falguni's daughter used to really be the guinea pig with me. She would have one type of foundation here, another type here, contour here. And they would be all with these big smiles because we were so excited. But it's been exactly that. It's been a dream creating this brand. And the wonderful thing is that Reena really understands exactly when I say that, listen, I don't like this texture, or I want this kind of texture, I want this kind of, you know, consistency. You know, she goes out there and she doesn't stop until she finds it.
Yeah. But, you know, before I go on further, guys, we have to acknowledge the stage. I mean, three incredible women on stage giving you the best of beauty. I think we need an applause for that. Come on.
Thank you.
Okay, next, I have something really exciting to introduce. It's a personal story before, anecdote. So, you know, one day I get a message, random message saying, hi, will you please call me back, Katrina Kaif? And I was like, what? Like, how many times in your life can you say you get a message from Katrina Kaif? And I was like, is somebody playing a prank on me? But she insists on getting on a call. And I think then for about like half an hour, we speak about your vision. I could really see her sincerity, her commitment to the brand, and how incredibly into she was, you know, in the whole what she wanted to bring out for people. And I was like, Katrina Kaif, the actor, is so consumed into what she wants to bring out to the world. And I was like, yes, I want to be a part of this campaign. And she's like, you know what, Zoya Akhtar is writing the movie, the film that we are going to show.
It's almost like a movie, though.
it
was that
movie.
Much work that it felt like this ad film was like a movie production.
But Katrina's information, Katrina's interest, and Katrina's involvement in the project really made me want to be a part of it. And she said she was working with Zoya Akhtar to create a film that would tell the story of this brand. Katrina, would you like to tell us about the film?
So, the film, because that's what it's like. It's been as much work as any, making a movie. So, it kind of all started one Sunday. So, the idea, I kind of knew what I wanted to say and what we wanted to say with K-Beauty. We wanted to speak to women. We didn't want to talk at women and tell them what we thought. We wanted to speak with them and to them. And there was a lot of discussion between us that, should we go this direction for our first campaign or this direction? One Sunday after... cups of coffee with Zoya and me and my girlfriends and all of us, and we were discussing this. We came up, Zoya said, let me just write something based on the conversations we've had between me and her, because, we meet almost every Sunday for a girl's lunch. And let me just, come up with something about everything I've heard you say, that I heard, us say about women and about makeup and about, how we feel about the brand. And one Sunday, we called up Falguni and Rina, and we went to Zoya's house on a Sunday, pulled Falguni out of her out of her house, and we went there, and Zoya read it out, and Falguni was like, this is it. I loved it because, we worked on it together, and it was, this is exactly what I want to say with K-Beauty. And after that, honestly, the team of women who I got together for this film, I can't tell you how grateful I am, because they're just such, everyone is incredible. I mean, as Kosha said, she's been so gracious to be a part of the film. To everyone else who's in the film, I want you to see the film first, but I mean, I can say it before as well. The Raja Kumari has done the voiceover for us, which just gives it that life, and so many incredible other women, which we can talk about after you see the film. What I really wanted it to be about was to showcase women from different professions who have different achievements and through their grit and determination have succeeded in their chosen profession. And also women who celebrate different kinds of looks and different kinds of beauty. And every person who's in the ad is someone who I personally love and admire. And really, really happy with it. It was a tough journey. I'm incredibly grateful to Zoya Akhtar too, who's written it for us, and she worked on it with me like it was her own baby, and Anita Shroff, who did the entire styling. It was like some 37 outfits, and we had like a weekend to do it. And she worked on it again, literally like it was her own brand. I mean, she took as much stress as I did. She was running up and down, helter skelter, and both of these women, I think, were all of us really grateful that they just, supported us like this. And can't wait for you to see it now.
Yes, yes. And before I introduce this film to you, I have to tell you that whatever you see in this film, it is not directed. Nobody's been told what to do. Literally, the brief was, be yourself, get your vibe in, do whatever you want to do. And everything that you see is what people, their own personalities, their own energies into it. So I'm very proud to introduce the film, hashtag It's K to Be You, written by Zoya Akhtar. Guys, to the screen.
How does it feel to be you? Are you easy with